Hey, what's up, YouTube? This is a AC Tesla machine, DC. Calling Tesla for short. I haven't made a video in a while, and what I'm going to do today is I'm going to try my first batch of partial home brewing. I'm going to do a partial, they call it mini mash, partial extract batch. And this is going to be my first batch and of partials, and I did like 6 extracts, and they all came out great. I mean, you got some brewers out there, no names to be mentioned, and they could, you know, they had problems with the tin can. I mean, I didn't have a problem with the tin can, but like others say, and Craig Tube out there, and some other guys out there, PEI home brewer, tin cans are good. It got me started. It gets a lot of people started in the craft, and like today, you know, here I am. I did about 6-7 tin cans, if you want to call it that, extract brewing, and they all came out great, but I'm looking to pick up my game a little bit, and here I am, you know, partial extract, and down the road, I'm going to do it definitely an all-grain, so probably in my next batch. So, but anyway, what I got here today is I'm going to show you some of these ingredients I got for my partial, and hopefully you can give some people an idea of what to use, and there's different ways of going about using different ingredients for different brews. So what I have today, what I'm going to try to do today is brew like a Belgian ale. What I got here is, I don't know if you can see it, it's right there, it's pale ale. Got this from a homebrew shop. It was pretty good delivery. It wasn't high gravity. It was actually Midwest Supplies, Minnesota, and the shipping was great. Price is a little better that I feel than high gravity, but anyway. This is 3 pounds of pale ale, Castle. This is like actually a Belgium barley malt. I had these pre-crushed. I'll probably crush them a little more with my rolling pin, because some of them, it doesn't look like it was fully crushed. We got 3 pounds of pale ale, Belgian Castle. I got 1 pound here of Cara 20. I don't know if you see that there. And this is more or less for flavor and head retention, and it's good for foam stability and things like that. And what I have here also is a pound of Carapils. I don't know if you see that too good. This is a pound of Carapils, and it also does the same thing with flavor and head retention, foam stability, and basically like a flavor and some color, especially with the Cara 20. This is like a 20 Lover Bond, I believe. And it gives it a darker color, as you can see. This is a little darker than the pale ale, of course. And along with that grain, I have here a 3.3 pound gold extract. I'll be using that as well. I got my little honey guy here. I used him in the past, and he's still wondering why I'm using him. He's like, what the hell did I do to this guy? I'm going into this bucket. But anyway, it's Mr. Honey. I got some honey here. And some of the recipes that I've seen in other, like in magazines and online, things like that, where people use coriander, all right? So I'm going to try that. I'm going to crush this up, probably throw a few whole ones in there, and also roll, like, crush a few of these and see what goes on with that, because I heard that's pretty good flavor right there, so I'm going to try that. Another thing, I heard like orange peel, so you try some orange peel extract, or actually orange peel, you can't really see that too well. Well, anyway, it says orange extract. This is pure orange extract, and it smells awesome. It smells just as, you know, orange peels, and it smells awesome, and I'm going to try it. Try a little bit of that. And we got our hops over here. I got bitterin hops over here. I got three different types of hops. This is a Yakima. I have a bad time focusing in on this camera. So, it's a Yakima Magnum pellet hop. Its alpha acids is 13.1. So this is actually a great bittering hop. This is an ounce. I'll be using a whole ounce for the bittering. Along with that, we also have an ounce of Hallertau. It's basically the hop that Budweiser is famous for. Hallertau. So Budweiser uses that quite a bit, or predominantly in all their brews, so in all the beer. Got that Hallertau, that's an ounce right there. Also, I got Liberty pellet hops. This is, I was told, similar to Hallertau. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right, Hallertau. But anyway, I heard this was also a good hop to use. So between the Yakima Magnums for the bittering, the Hallertau, I'll probably use that for the flavoring. And then what I'll do is like maybe use a half ounce for the aroma with the Liberty. And then I'll put a half ounce in for a dry hop with the Liberty as well. So, and I got my one step here. I got my sanitizer in a bottle. I got my, let's see what I got in here. I got my hydrometer in here. I got my paddle. I got my racking cane. I got my carboy clip for my racking. I got my little airlock here, three-piece airlock. I got my thermometer in there. A spoon, things like that. All the good stuff you're gonna need here. That's my ingredient list, my shipping list that I got. It has all my ingredients on there. Show you over here. This is my water going here. I just took a temperature on this. I'll take another temperature on it. I want to get it to about 165, because when I put the 5 pounds of grains in there, or 4 pounds of grains, I should say, this water temperature will drop quite a bit. I heard about 10 degrees it'll drop, so I'm looking for about 165. And what we're at about is about 160, looks like about 162. And I'm gonna hire this flame up a little bit, and I'm gonna get up to about 165, and then I'll just bring the flame down a little bit and add my grains, and I'll just let that steep for about an hour. And then over here, I'm going to have this, actually it's heating as we speak, and this will be my sparge water. I got about a gallon, I got close to about 1.75 gallons in this big bucket here. And in this bucket here, I got exactly about a gallon. I'm going to use that for sparge water. I'll heat this up to about 170. When this is done steeping, because I got my grain bag, that's the one thing I didn't show you. My grains will be steeping in the grain bag. I have that going for about an hour, 60 minutes, and then after that, this is my sparge water, which will be about 170. And let me show you that grain bag I got. This is a nice size grain bag. I like it a lot. It's kind of huge. I thought it'd be too big, but I just put all the grains in there, and that's basically what you need, man. I don't know if you can catch that on there. It's pretty long, but it's basically what you're going to need to put about 5 pounds of grains in there. So, and kind of excited here, man. This is pretty cool because this is my first partial, and I think I'm on the right track, and hopefully everything works out good. I'll give you an update on the next process. This is just the heating of the water and the grain steeping, and I showed you the ingredients over here. So, and I'll get back to you guys soon. Take care.